live from Haines City, welcome to the LRB Tonight Show starring Jamie Carson. I'm Ann McMahon, and along with Doc Lanny Severinsen and the LRB Orchestra, including Tony, we invite you to join Jamie and her guests, some of whom you'll remember and some you'll never forget. So sit back and enjoy the show. And now, here's Jamie. It's nice to know that something besides your teeth come out at night. Seriously, we have a good show for you tonight. We hope it'll bring a little bit of laughter to you this evening. And this time last year, we were not able to put a show on because of the pandemic. And I think everybody here in some way or another has been affected by it. I know I was every day, every night, for months and months and months. With my husband. That's right. We nearly drove each other crazy. But I think he finally realized I was just about to go bonkers. He comes in the kitchen with this huge map of the world, and he tacks it up on the wall. He said, Janie, I know you've been in this house with me for months. He said, here's a dart. Throw the dart wherever it lands. I will take you there. That was nice, wasn't it?
That was very nice.
We're going to be spending 2 weeks behind the refrigerator. Never was a new car. Never was a good with cars. Listen, we got to get the show on the road so you can get home in time to take your teeth out before you go to bed tonight. So we're going to get started right after this word from our sponsor, Chiquita Banana.
Thank you.
favorite from the Carol Burnett Show. Let's watch as they bring us their own rendition of the segment, Gone with the Wind. On a bobtail nag, and I bet two bits on the bay. Doop-dop, doop-dop. Hey, well, just a minute. Well, never mind about me, because he said he was coming by to see you today.
Today? I can't let him see me look like this. I look like the inside of a goat's belly.
Oh, Miss Charlotte, he's coming up the lane now.
Oh, no. He's coming up. What am I going to do? I can't let him see me in these rags.
Well, you could hide behind the drapes.
The drapes.
Oh, the drapes. I've seen that look before.
You keep Mr. Butler busy. I have a dress to make to cover up these rags.
I'll try. Well, hello, Mr. Butler. How are you?
How are you? How are you? You ask a man just back from the war, watching the world crumble to pieces, and you ask a man, how are you? How are you?
Yeah, I'm fine, how are you?
Listen, I'm a man of few issues. I wish this war had never happened. I wish I was in the land of
time. I don't want to be back there.
Old times there, not forgotten. Look away.
Look away.
Look away, Dixieland.
Hey, that's kind of catchy, Mr. Butler. You ought to set that to music.
Well, yeah. Is Miss Scarlett here?
Oh, she stepped out for a minute, but she'll be right back. I hope.
Yeah, me too.
Miss Charlotte. She'll be here in a minute.
Taxes on my plantation, Tara. But these girls fell in love with Lollipop, and it isn't a boy. Let's find out who they fell in love with. Here to perform is our very own group with My Boy Lollipop.
Red Riding Hood. You have an eye doctor, Red? Yeah, you do. Well, if I were you, girl, I'd look at getting a new one. Oh, my. Good heavens. You know, just to see that you don't get a chance, I think I ought to walk with you for a ways. What full lips you have.
Blanket is there. I love you, Linda. unmanageable anyhow.
Darling, what do you mean? Oh, darling. Well, you should know. Being married to the same woman for 57 years to the very day.
Oh, I'm getting the blue now. You think I forgot our anniversary, don't you?
I think you'd forget your head if it wasn't glued on to take your chair doll with.
Don't you worry about my memory.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Well, when was the last time you took out the trash?
1965.
1965?
Yep, that's the year I threw your brother out of the house.
Did forget our anniversary.
Are you sure?
Well, I haven't seen a card. Haven't seen any candy. And the only flowers that I've seen was printed on the toilet tissue.
Well, there still might be a surprise for you later on tonight.
Don't give me that old trick. If I haven't gotten it by now, I'm not going to get it at all.
You know, I think I remember our anniversary better than you do. You remember what I got you for our birthday anniversary?
Jerry, that's been 57 years ago.
I remember. I got us a pair of matching snow sleds.
And we've been going downhill ever since.
You remember what I got you for our 40th anniversary? I do. That's your beautiful black see-through negligee.
When I got you that electric blanket.
Yeah. Neither one of them warmed me up.
Boy, if I didn't have a reason to be mad before, I do now.
Hold it, I know you got me. I'm going to give you a gift later on tonight.
Dark?
Yeah.
Well, if it's what I think it is, it's not even worth unwrapping.
Seriously, Linda, when's the last time we, you know...
The last time we, you know... We what?
The pencil on our friggin' was full.
I remember.
You do when?
Well, I don't remember when, but I remember what it was called.
Oh, I'm only joking. I'm going to give you a gift later on, tonight, upstairs.
Yeah, you're kidding, all right?
I'm just kidding you.
I know you are.
Well, you think this would be worth unwrapping?
Oh, Jerry, you remember.
Sure.
You didn't forget.
No.
Oh, look, they're beautiful. They're gorgeous.
Yes, and every one of them pearls represent the year that we were married. And every one is just as perfect as the one before, just like our marriage.
Oh, they're just beautiful. And they are just matched so well.
What have you been married 57? 7 years. Do you have a secret that you can share with us?
Well,
as to why you've been married so long?
Well, we usually go out to eat twice a week.
Yeah, figured out on Wednesday, I'd go out on Friday.
And we usually hold the ants on the floor.
Yeah.
Sweet.
Yeah. That's real sweet.
Yeah.
I know you're all excited.
Well, we're out in on the town over the hand. I have to hold on to her tight because if I don't, people have to go off their shopping somewhere.
Well, Jerry, I think your anniversary gift was a wonderful gift for you. And I see a twinkle in your eye. I know you're ready to get out of here. So you guys go and enjoy the rest of your evening.
Good night.
All right. As she sings Mercedes-Benz.
Oh my God, look at all these sexy hippies. Oh my God. This is like Woodstock all over again. Anybody got an extra puff? Oh, I see. Yeah, I'll be there later. Oh yeah, baby. Okay, you are my music right now. I had a rough night getting here, I tell you. Well, we're gonna sing this song, and hopefully we'll get through. I'm gonna use a little help from you. We're gonna do this. Oh Lord, won't you buy me a Mercedes-Benz? My friends all drive precious, I must make amends. Work hard all my lifetime, no help from my friends. A Mercedes-Benz. Oh Lord, won't you buy me a color TV? Dial it for a dollar, it's trying to find me. I wait for delivery each day until 3. Oh Lord, won't you buy me a color TV? Oh Lord, won't you buy me a night on the town? I'm counting on you, Lord, please don't let me down. You've got to love me and buy the next round. Oh Lord, won't you buy me a night on the town? Everybody, oh Lord, won't you buy me a Mercedes-Benz? My friends all drop precious, I must make names dance. I worked hard all my lifetime, no hail from my friends. A Mercedes. Oh, baby!
Oh, groovy! Yeah. Come on over and have a seat.
Oh, I could lay down right now, actually.
Oh, I understand you've been taking some pretty psychedelic medication.
Oh, you have no idea. Well, let me tell you just a little bit about it. So, the bus arrived last night. Hey. Man. So, Janie, we got in, and the first place we went was Mustang. And let me tell you, I'm not talking Mustang like horses. We went down to some street called Mustang. So they said, hey, there's some good stuff going on Mustang. I said, all right, I'm in for it. Like, groovy, man. So we go down Mustang, you know, we're meandering down the road, and just to the right of me, oh Lord, I mean, just prior to this, I had a couple of Pfizer, 2 Moderna, 1 AstraZeneca. Whoa, baby. Just here, just to the right of me, I see this thing sitting up above this tall. I thought, what in tarnation is that? That's a dog. No, I saw at the front gate, no pets in this park. It's not a dog. It's a friggin' horse. That's the guy's ride. How else is he getting back and forth to Walmart? Like, really? I thought, is it Mr. Ed? Wilbur. Nope, wasn't him. So I thought, that's cool, I'm good with that. Popped another couple of little Pfizer, head it down, you know, do my thing, kind of getting ready for the show. And here I am. But nonetheless, I go a little further down, and I turn on to, I think it was called Bay Avenue or something like that. And there's a lake right there. It's a real pretty spot. So I'm going down there. What do I see on the end of two leashes? Gator bites. Now, don't they know that they're not allowed to feed gators here in Florida? Two little gator bites like this. I couldn't believe my eyes. I thought, Lord have mercy, things are really happening. So I went over to this other place, Prairie. I could smell this delicious, I don't know what it was. They call her the pie lady. They said, hey, Janice, if you want some good brownies, you know what I'm talking about? And I think we've all had some. Yeah, well, I tell you, they're the best brownies ever. Pies are good, but brownies are like sweet. So, had a couple of those. And I'm heading back now to the clubhouse. I thought, you know, I'm feeling pretty damn good. Oh no, darn good. It is Sunday. So, feeling pretty good. I'm heading back to the clubhouse. I'll get myself all organized. I'm heading back, and what do I see? Oh my God, it looks like a sunset. It's the biggest ball of fire I ever did see. And as I get closer to this thing, like, it's coming at me. I'm thinking, he's coming to get me. It's like, it's my time. Well, no. All of a sudden, I hear, Janice, it's me, Jimmy. It's Jimmy. Well, the only Jimmy I knew was Jimi Hendrix. He's been gone a long time. Well, this son had purple sock on this foot. He had a stripe thing going on here, and he's coming at me like this. Well, I thought, okay, praise the Lord, I am definitely going to that sermon. I am definitely going to that sermon with Richard Horner, because I need a little help. Anyway, you know, life goes on, and if anybody ever needs any good stuff, come visit me backstage, like, you know, we got some stuff happening back there. Oh yeah, we do.
No, I think you've answered about any question I might ask you. No, we can get the show over.
No, let me tell you. I just read your new autobiography. When I was sitting in the bus because they're waiting to get gas, you know how long it takes to fill up when you're bumming money to get the gas tank full? I mean, like, honest to God. Fun with Dick and Jane, written by Ed. She has definitely got to join me backstage. I got a couple of tokes for you, baby.
Weird Al.
dresses, Alice?
Oh, yeah, we go to Walmart. We go everything. Sometimes we go with the print on. See a lot of print books. So that's where we go.
Okay, now have you ever tried our Walmart mall down here?
Yes, I did. I went there one day. Went over there, and it was closed, but there was underwear in there.
Oh.
I'm a jockey, so I threw them away.
All right.
I am not wearing them, I swear.
Okay,
so.
Well, we'll just leave that there.
Okay.
Thank you very much for joining us, and thank you for bringing your crew.
Thank you, everybody, for coming.
I love their tacky outfits. Visitor from the Far East, the seer, sage, all-knowing, Karnak the Magnificent. Greetings from the South.
Greetings from the West.
Okay. Well, I just thought to myself, you've been visiting us for 20 years.
Yes, I have.
Wonderful when you come to visit us. It's always so enlightening for us.
Thank you.
I hold in my hands the envelopes. A child of four could see that the envelopes have been hermetically sealed. They have been held in a mayonnaise jar on LRB President's front porch since noon today. No one knows the contents of these envelopes except you, and your mystical and borderline divine powers will ascertain the answers to these questions, having never before seen the questions. Isn't that true, madam?
Yes, that's true.
All right, okay. I just like to tell them what's coming up, you know, so they know there's some humor coming.
Well, let's get this show on.
All right, I hold in my hand envelope number one, hermetically sealed.
The question is, or the answer is, a walk through the cactus garden.
A walk through the cactus garden.
A walk through the cactus garden.
Yes, there's an echo in here.
The question is, what is the quickest way to get a needle in your butt? Arf, arf, arf.
Arf, arf, arf.
What do you hear in an OPEC park?
Irish heritage. This song dates back to the time when there was a little bit of a disagreement between the Green and the Orange Irish. The Orange Irish were the Protestant Irish, and the Green Irish were Catholic Irish.
I understand this song is called The Greatest Mix-Up?
Yes, ma'am, it is.
All right, you have the floor. Let's hear it.
Absolutely. Oh, it is the biggest mix-up that you have ever seen. Me father, he was orange, and my mother, she was green. Me father was a Protestant, not Protestant was he. My mother was a Catholic girl from County Cork, was she. They were married in two churches and fell madly in love until the day that I was born and things got rather tough. Oh, it is the biggest mix-up that you have ever seen. Me father, he was orange, and me mother, she was green. Baptized my father, Riley, I was rushed away by car. He made a loyal orange man, me father, shining star. I was christened David Anthony, but still, in spite of that, to me father, I was William, while me mother called me Pat. Oh, it is the biggest mix-up that you have ever seen. Me father, he was orange, and me mother, she was green. With mom, every Sunday, to mass, I proudly stroll. And then after that, the Orange Lodge would try to save my soul. Both sides tried to claim me, but I was smart because I played the flute or played the harp, depending where I was. Oh, it is the biggest mix-up that you have ever seen. Me father, he was orange, and me mother, she was green. Just then, God's relations came round to visit me. Just as my father's kinfolk were all setting down to tea, we tried to smooth things over, but they all began to fight. And me being strictly neutral, I bashed everyone in sight. Oh, it is the biggest mix-up that you have ever seen. Me father, he was orange, and me mother, she was green. Me parents could not agree upon my type of school. That's why my learning was all done at home. That's why I'm such a fool. They both passed on God rest them, but left me caught between the awful color problem of the orange and the green. Oh, it is the biggest mix-up that you have ever seen. Me father, he was orange, and me mother, she was green.
Grandma, we can do this the easy way, or bought you some chocolate chip cookies. You're on me counter.
Cookies? Awesome.
Make sure that Annabeth gets on the favorites.
No! Mom, you leave me no choice. If you're going to watch Annabeth, then you're going to have to follow our rules. And that means no sugar. It means being in bed by 9 p.m. It means eating what everyone else eats for dinner. And it means no more than an hour of TV. Mom, are you even listening to me?
Oh, look. I just got this for Annabeth. You think she'll like that? I think it's adorable.
Oh, she would look adorable.
I thought so, too. So, excuse me. I'm going to go see if Annabeth's ready. I told her we'd go for some ice cream.